Mental health is important in this nation, important in the world, and the Semel Institute is a leader.
The Semel Institute is a very big part of UCLA, one of the largest research and education units on campus. What we look at is the full range of mental disorders, neurologic disorders, and try to find ways to help patients recover more quickly. This is a place where new discoveries are made every day. We're at the cutting edge of scientific discovery, but scientific discovery in the public interest.
We have an extraordinary group of faculty and students and staff, and that's really the exemplar piece. It's the people that make the difference.
The Semel Institute, with its focus on research and teaching about mental health, plays a critical role on campus. It's part of the larger health ecosystem on campus, and it's highly integrated with the hospital, with the neuroscience department, and with other types of expertise nearby.
The Friends of the Semel Institute is the support group for the world-renowned Semel Institute for Neuroscience and Human Behavior at UCLA.
It's the Friends that is really helping us stay at the cutting edge of both research and clinical care.
From early childhood to senior illnesses, the research here covers a lifespan.
The Friends Scholar Program really has become a linchpin of our research support here. This is one of the few programs that specifically targets, that pinpoints the most promising young researchers and says, we're going to give you 2 years of support to launch your ideas.
A little bit of seed money from the Friends of the Semel allows a young investigator to obtain some preliminary data, which they can then submit to the NIH to get a much larger grant.
The atmosphere right now is that there is really a lack of funding and support out there.
The Friends of Semel has given me an incredible and unique opportunity to really become a primary investigator early on in my career.
This is a pretty incredible research environment, and the number of specialty clinics, the number of cutting edge researchers, the facilities are really second to none.
The Friends Scholar Program is really helping to protect and helping to develop the next generation of researchers at UCLA.
ECPHP is a short-term program for children on the autism spectrum or at risk of having autism. The children that come to this program are in need of intensive intervention, something that they are not getting in the field at this point. I just received a Christmas card from a family who their child was actually kicked out of an elementary school kindergarten class.
Raisins and oatmeal, I need that.
And we were able to work with the school, improve his goals, improve his behaviors, and now the principal can't believe how well he's doing.
The particular project that I've been pursuing focuses on understanding how our current evidence-based treatments for anxiety work. So the current treatment of choice is something called cognitive behavior therapy, and one thing that we need to understand a bit more is how this treatment works at the neural levels.
We've taken a whole person approach to our research, trying to understand how whole body treatments, such as yoga, tai chi, meditation, cognitive behavioral therapy, can all be combined or used separately to impact these processes of emotional health and physical well-being.
At first, I was frightened by the diagnosis, and slowly I was able to regain my self-confidence to a point where I reflect a very positive outlook.
What this has taught us is that our life has a future.
Caregivers who report psychological stress or strain are actually at a 63% risk of early death. My research project is to develop a new meditation and mindfulness intervention for family dementia caregivers.
People with serious mental illnesses are dying about 20 to 25 years before their peers. We train them to do what's called a for them, with them, by them intervention. The individual is expected to take on more and more responsibility until they ultimately take care of their own health care needs.
One of the extraordinary things that's happened with our research that the Semel has supported is in the neurobehavior genetics program, where we have a sequencing and genotyping core that allows us to sequence hundreds of human genomes now a month. Over the last 3 years, we and our collaborators have identified literally dozens of new genes that cause autism. So having these machines, it's critical, and it's made us one of the leading centers in neurogenetics.
The work we do with veterans here in Los Angeles goes into a number of realms. So one of our big projects is a web-based avatar world called Focus World, where families can enter an account together. They can work on emotional regulation skills. There's a communication tool to share their experience. And it's done in a fun and engaging way, but they're able to develop skills that will help them cope with stress.
I've seen so many children after an injury that they've sustained playing their sport. They're having post-concussive symptoms for months, and being unable to return makes it so common for them to have either anxiety or depression.
A number of years ago, a new treatment became available that was FDA approved called transcranial magnetic stimulation. And to launch a new treatment system with that equipment required a substantial capital investment. And so the friends made that possible.
TMS is a good alternative for people for whom medication has failed.
Lord knows I've tried medications, and talking therapy is wonderful, but for some of us it just doesn't compute.
What TMS does is induces an electrical field right under where the magnet is. Over time, it has a robust antidepressant effect.
All of a sudden, I realized that the emotions were not taking control. And for somebody who's been overly emotional most of their life, that's a big deal.
When I think about the Semel Institute, I really do think about optimism. Optimism being able to address some of the most serious issues with mental illness today. New technologies, you know, functional brain imaging, along with a whole set of new techniques and approaches really give us hope that we're going to be able to really crack issues that we couldn't have done, you know, a decade ago or two decades ago.